Hello, good morning students. Today we are going to learn about the different types of neurons. So in another video, in the last previous video, you have seen different types of neurons were discussed: sensory neuron, motor neuron, and the association neuron, that is relay neurons. The same thing is here, but in another name: afferent nerves, efferent nerves, and association nerves. So afferent nerves are, you if you see it very keenly or analyze this, we can see that the afferent nerves are nerves which collect information from the muscles of the organ, from the organs, and carry messages or signals to the brain or spinal cord. So they are sensory neurons. So sensory neurons are also called afferent neurons. Afferent neurons always collect the signals from the, or carry, not collect, but carry the signals from the muscles of the organs to the brain or spinal cord. Now, the second type of neurons or nerves are efferent nerves. Efferent nerves are motor nerves. They carry messages from the brain or spinal cord to the muscles of the organs. Efferent nerves carry messages from the brain or spinal cord to the organ, to the body parts. Now, for connecting the afferent nerves and efferent nerves, there are association nerves. They connect the brain, spinal cord, by the afferent and efferent nerves. Afferent nerves give messages to the brain and spinal cord. The efferent muscles carry messages from the brain and spinal cord, and to connect them, there are association nerves. So there is one more pathway. Different nerve pathways are given here. Nerve pathways are given here. Peripheral nervous system and the central nervous system is associated. How they are associated? The relationship between the different kind of neurons, all are given here in this diagram. See, central nervous system, which include the brain and spinal cord, CNS, central nervous system. This central nervous system, it also contain nerves which carry messages from the brain and spinal cord or towards the brain and spinal cord. Now, in the central nervous system, the nerves involved carry messages, the axon terminal and the dendrite of another neuron, the axon terminal of one neuron and the dendrite of another neuron, they are connecting by a connecting neuron. They are connected by a connecting neuron. See, this is also a neuron. This is the effector or sensory neuron. Receptor organ is here. Here is the receptor organ, maybe any sense organ. Any sense organ it will be. In the sense organ there is receptor nerves and the receptor organ, and the receptor organ receive sensory neuron, sensory receptor organ receive messages through the sensory neuron. The sensory neuron carry messages, effector carry messages. Here the message is transported to the next neuron, which is a connecting neuron, relay neuron, connecting neuron or inter neuron. And now here there is synapse, a gap. In this gap the electrical impulse is converted into chemical signals, neurotransmitters, and then the next cell body of the next neuron or dendrites of the next neuron, that is the effector neuron, motor neuron. They carry messages, that message to the muscle or nerve. They carry that message to the, so here, from here it is transported to the brain, and from the brain a neuron transmitted to the effector neuron. From the sense organ, from the receptor organ, it is carried to the brain or spinal cord. Here brain or spinal cord is not shown, here it is only written central nervous system. So here it is the spinal cord. Spinal cord of central nervous system is here. Here the message is carried and bring here in the spinal cord. After that, from the spinal cord it is converted as a command, converted into a command. Then this is the relay neuron, connecting neuron to the motor neuron. So the sensory neuron and the motor neuron are connected by relay neurons or interneurons. Now the effector organ, that is the motor neuron, that send a signal to axon terminal, from the axon terminal to the effector organ. Effector organ is the muscle or any organ. It can be a muscle. Effector organ. Okay. Now, another thing, very important thing we have to learn is the structure of brain. Brain. Draw neat and well labeled diagram of human brain and explain its parts and their function. So this is the structure of brain. Brain is, you have to draw this diagram and explain its parts and the function of each part. Brain has three parts. Before learning the parts, we may go through a close look on the covering of the brain. Brain is the most, one of the most important organ in our body. It is a control center of all actions in our, that take place in our body. So it should be covered very properly with a hard covering. It is very must. To save it from injury, to save the brain from injury, it should be covered properly. For that, there is a very hard skeletal structure which is called the skull. So skull is the outermost covering. That is skull or cranium. It is also called cranium. In a common language, it is called skull. So skull is the outer covering. So we commonly say, where does the brain situated in our body? Inside the head. Inside the head. So in the head, you know, there is a very hard covering which is called skull in the head. So and covering that head, there is hairs. There are hairs. So this skull, the inner part of the skull, has a membranous covering which is called meninges. A membranous covering. Not only three layered membranous covering is there, that is called meninges. And inside the meninges, a fluid is filled in the brain to absorb shock. A fluid is filled in the brain. And these are all provided for giving protection to the brain. And inside to that, there is almost 80% of the brain is covered by the main part, that is cerebrum. The front part of the brain is called cerebrum. And back to that, there are two more parts. Almost in the middle, there is midbrain. And at the back of the head, there is hindbrain. Hindbrain contains two parts, cerebellum and medulla. Cerebellum and medulla. And in the middle part, there is hypothalamus, pituitary gland. Behind that, there is hind brain. So brain is mainly divided into three parts: forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Forebrain contains cerebrum, midbrain contains hypothalamus, pituitary, and some areas where reflex action is controlled. The hindbrain has pons, medulla, and cerebellum, and followed by spinal cord. Okay, this is the structure. Here it is given in written. You have to write it in your copy. After drawing that diagram, you have to write this explanation. In one more page, it is there, all the parts. Human brain is a highly complex organ which is mainly composed of the nervous tissue. The tissues are highly folded to accommodate a larger surface area in less space. That is why the cerebral part of the brain is folded, highly folded area to accommodate larger surface area. The brain is covered by a three-layered system of membranes called meninges. We explained already. Cerebrospinal fluid is filled between the meninges. So in the meninges, in between the three layers, a fluid is filled which is called cerebrospinal fluid, which help it from shock, which save the brain from shock. It acts as a shock absorber. The cerebrospinal fluid provide cushion to the brain against mechanical shocks. Furthermore, the brain is housed inside the skull for optimum protection. The human brain can be divided into three regions: forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Parts of forebrain: it is composed of cerebrum, midbrain composed of hypothalamus, hindbrain composed of cerebellum, pons, and medulla. Medulla, full name of medulla is medulla oblongata. And some main structures of the human brain are explained here. Cerebrum, what is the function of cerebrum? Actually, this cerebrum is divided into two hemispheres, which are called cerebral hemispheres. The cerebrum controls voluntary motor actions in human beings. Voluntary motor actions. Voluntary actions are always actions, the actions which take place according to the will of the individual. Voluntary actions. The will of the individual. According to the will. For example, what are the voluntary actions take place? Walking, running, are all voluntary actions. Voluntary motor actions there. Writing. We use our fingers to write. It is an voluntary action, not an involuntary action. Walking, running, dancing, all are controlled by, these voluntary actions are controlled by cerebrum. It is also the site of sensory perceptions. Sensory perceptions like what? Auditory, tactile, etc. It is the seat of learning and memory. So cerebrum control thinking, learning, memory, etc. And next is hypothalamus. The midbrain contains hypothalamus. Hypothalamus lies at the base of the cerebrum. It controls sleep and wake cycle, which is called circadian cycle, circadian rhythm of the body. It also controls the urges for eating and drinking, the thirst and hunger, which control the controlling part of thirst and hunger is hypothalamus in our body. So we feel hungry or thirst because of this part control all the such urges of thirst and hunger. Then cerebellum lies below the cerebrum and at the back of the whole structure. So it coordinates the motor functions. What type of motor functions? जैसे you have to balancing actions. You have to balance many a time when cycling, when walking, dancing, or whatever you do. You have to keep balancing. When you are riding your bicycle, perfect coordination between your pedaling and steering control is achieved by the cerebellum. So it control your balance and equilibrium of the body. Balance and equilibrium. Medulla forms the brain stem. From the medulla, the spinal cord is extended. Along with the pons, it lies at the base of the brain and continues into the spinal cord. Medulla controls various involuntary actions like here be hearing, respiration, heartbeat, all are controlled by the medulla. Heartbeat is controlled by medulla, and hearing, involuntary actions. Heartbeat, it is heartbeat, not hearing. Okay, this is heartbeat. T is missing here. T is missing here. Heartbeat, not hearbeat. Heartbeat, respiration, all are controlled by medulla. Okay. So now this is all about the structure and function of brain. Draw this diagram and write down that. Okay. This is all about before summer vacation topic. This is all about before summer vacation. Now, on Monday you will get summer vacation homework. Do it in your classwork copy only. Do your summer vacation homework in your classwork copy. That is this copy, in which you are doing all these works. Don't take a separate copy for that. Okay. So do the pending work also. I have seen that only 10 or 12 students have shown me the notes of chapter 6. Only 12 students. I count them. Only 12. Only a dozen out of 100 students. Almost there are 100 students now in class 10. Out of 100, only 12 students show me the notes. That means only 12 completed their notes, and they are also not completed the notes completely. Only 5 or 6 students completed it. Others is yet to complete their diagrams. Okay, and what about the other 88? They did not even write the question answers. If they, then they will, they appear in front of me. They did not complete their question answers even. This is the picture. So you have to do your pending work in the vacation. The main thing is that you have to do your pending work in the vacation, because after the vacation we are going to face the exam. Okay. Okay. Then till I wish you all a very happy summer vacation, and enjoy your vacation at home. Stay at home, stay safe, stay healthy. Okay, thank you.